Hi everyone, Pastor Ralph here. Welcome to another segment of Coffee with Pastor Ralph. I trust you've got your cup full. I trust you have your Bible. I trust you have your pen and pencil in hand and a mind and a spirit to hear what God is saying to us. I think all of us would agree that one of the greatest disciplines, most important discipline that any Christian can practice is the discipline of prayer. We all know we should do it. We all want to do it. We all say that we want to take time to do it. But when it comes down to actually practicing the discipline of prayer, let's be honest, if you're like me, it doesn't always happen the way that we envision. We read books by great prayer warriors like E.M. Bounds and Oswald Chambers, and we think, man, if we could just pray like them. Well, I've got good news for you, that not only are you feeling, if you're feeling alone in this, you're not, because I'm right there too. I want to have a more disciplined prayer life. I want to have not just a disciplined prayer life. I want to have an effective prayer life. I want to be able to pray with power and that comes out of an intimacy with God, our Heavenly Father. And I know you do too. And so for the next few weeks, as we share together on these next few moments, we're going to look at a study that was written by Craig Gracial called Dangerous Prayers. And it's all in line with the prayer emphasis that we are making for September, the 21 days of prayer. As we move forward into our building for the fall, as we look at post-COVID with all of its attending questions, what's going to happen next? We want to enter this next season with a heart filled with a desire to seek God's will to be done here in Sydney as it is in heaven. So I want you to come with me for the next few weeks, and we are going to look at what prayer is about, not just prayer. Because let's face it, you hear the word prayer and go, oh yeah, another study on prayer, another guilt trip that I should pray. No, that's not what this is about. But what I do want to challenge us about is that God wants us to take our prayer lives that are mundane, routine, traditional, and God wants us to change our prayer life into something effective, something powerful, something essential. And so let's just pray for a moment, and then we're going to delve right into our study together. Father, I just pray for the next few minutes, Lord, that you would just lead and guide us. And Father, I pray that you would just minister by your grace today to everyone who is listening in as we study together in Jesus' name. Amen. This study is called Dangerous Prayers. Let me just read an example of some of these dangerous prayers from the Word of God. In 1 Samuel chapter 1, Naomi comes to God in prayer wanting a son, and she prays boldly, "I ask the Lord to give me this boy, and he has granted my request." Talk about boldness in prayer, to actually ask God specifically for a son. And amazingly, God gives her son, and then she returns that son in dedication to the Lord's service. Then we read in Matthew chapter 6, the disciples ask Jesus, "Teach us to pray." So notice what he says. We all know this. "Pray like this," Jesus said, "Our Father in heaven, may your name be kept holy, may your kingdom come, may your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today the food we need, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And don't lead us into temptation, but rescue us from evil." Man, this is a dangerous prayer. This is not a humdum routine prayer. This isn't just a liturgical prayer, but this is a model for us all to take God at his word, to ask him for exactly what we need. Then in Psalm 59, the psalmist David writes, Rescue me from my enemies, O God. Protect me from those who have come to destroy me. Rescue me from these criminals. Save me from these murderers. This is another faith-filled, dangerous prayer. He is in deep trouble. He's in agony. He is in crisis. You know, there are two times that we often fail in prayer. One is when things are growing really well. We figure, who needs God? But then there are times we go through crisis when the world seems to be falling all around us. And the temptation is to just throw our hands up and say, what more can be done? But God is calling us in these days to pray, especially in days of crisis. Another prayer of David in Psalm 34:17 says, the Lord hears his people when they call to him for help. He rescues them from all their troubles. So yeah, if you're in a crisis right now and you feel the world is falling all around you and you have nowhere to turn and it feels as if you take another step, you're going to fall over the edge. Guess what? God says, call on me because he hears me. He hears you and he hears your call for help. So what has all this got to do with dangerous prayers? Well, let's be honest. If you're like me, sometimes we fall into the place where our prayers are in a rut. They're routine. They're repetitive. They're predictable. They are safe. Yet the Bible says that we serve a God who can do more than we could ever ask or imagine. So guess what? It's time to stop playing it safe. God has created us for a life not just of comfort and ease, but he's called us to live a life of passion that's filled with power and charged with a desire to change the world in radical ways. And it comes through prayer. A prayer that is not flat, dull, predictable, stale, or boring, but a prayer that's so much more. It's a prayer that seeks to communicate with God in real, vulnerable, and intimate ways. You see, he wants to wrap his arms around us, not just to keep us in a safe bubble, but he's wanting to hold us and to carry us and to help us move through whatever it is we're facing. So let me ask you this morning, are you ready for more? Are you sick of playing it safe? Are you ready for praying daring, faith-filled, God-honoring, life-changing, world-transforming prayers? Then join me in the next few weeks as we learn together. It's time to stop praying it safe. It's time to start talking and listening to God. It's time for dangerous prayers. God bless you. Pastor Ralph signing off, wishing you a blessed day. And always remember, keep your cup full.